What is up, guys? It's DJ here. I'm here to share a songwriting tip with you. I know Tyler and Daniel are doing their own tips on things like production and the music industry slash business side of things, but I am primarily going to be sharing what is hopefully many tips over the next couple or next few weeks with you guys. And this is the first one. I really want to kind of do this step by step as well. So if you watch each video in order, it should be kind of the order as to how I, in particular, write my own songs. This can differ from person to person. Maybe for you, step three comes first. Maybe for you, you're like me, and what I tell you today is gonna be the first thing that works for you as well. But whatever works, works for everybody individually. So my first step is to get inspired. That is step one. Step one, get inspired. This can happen through a number of things. And for me, I find that other music, other forms of entertainment, other things that inspire me. I know that a lot of artists think that to be an artist, you have to just create from yourself. And that's true. Everything that you make is your own. But I think all of us, if you're a musician, you became a musician in the first place because you heard someone else as a musician. You saw Jimi Hendrix playing on television, or you heard, you know, Bono and U2 singing a song or something, or some sort of artist that you were listening to made you just kind of, you know, none of us just woke up one day and just said, oh, I just want to be a musician, you know, or, oh, I just want to be a guitarist, or, oh, I want to be a songwriter. I think at the end of the day, there's always some sort of other artist or some song, even if we didn't know the artist, there's some form of music that we heard that made us in our head go, man, I also want to create that. I think the same goes for people that are filmmakers. The same goes for sketch artists and any kind of visual artists. I think there's always some sort of inspiration that leads us to want to also create ourselves. So I think that there's nothing wrong with continuing that form of inspiration, that form of finding inspiration in order to write songs. You've seen through our videos and sessions that each song we do is inspired by some sort of already popular song. It's not a copy by any means, and what we do for sessions is a little bit more based around the song. I think, you know, for my own personal stuff and what we do outside of sessions, most of the time if we hear a song for inspiration, it's for specific things. Maybe I like the way the drum tone is in a song, or maybe the way the way the person wrote their lyrics for a song, whatever. But for sessions, we have really been taking songs and been saying, okay, here are the components that make this song. Let's make a top 40 song that really kind of uses those components as well. And we do our own twists, use our own chord progressions. But at the end of the day, you've got a song that is honestly very unique, very itself, but you can also still hear the hints that come from that original song. And so there's never anything wrong with doing that, you know, for your own stuff. I mean, because we are really using the components of these original songs to make our own, that's why we're really able to create a full song and a full production within one day, you know. But for all of our solo projects, you know, songs can take up to 2 days, to a whole week, to multiple weeks, to months, even years. I've had songs that have taken me 3 or 4 years to finish, probably longer than it should take. But really, we're artists. We yearn for perfection, and there's nothing wrong with that. But again, I just want to make sure that the main focus of this video is for you to understand that a really great way for you to start writing a song, or if you're in the middle of a song, again, maybe this is not step one for you, maybe this is step 7 or 8, a good way to be inspired when you get hit by writing blocks is totally to listen to music. I know I do that all the time. I listen to my own stuff often in the car, but more than I listen to my own stuff, I listen to a lot of music, mainstream stuff, stuff that came out years ago, classic rock, all sorts of music. And that's the other thing I wanted to make sure that I got across in this video is don't be afraid to listen to things you've never heard before. If you're always recycling the same sound over and over again, chances are you're not going to be able to create anything new. And so it's super important to listen to all sorts of things. I remember when I first got involved with Daniel and Tyler, and we were working in the studio, and I remember a lot of the clients that we had in, it was such a mix. You know, you've got rappers, you've got pop artists, you've got rock bands, and then country artists. I maybe really enjoyed already before working with them, maybe two of those genres, like rock and rap, But I hated pop and I hated country. But I was forced to work with these clients, and I think over time, and honestly, I'll say right now, I love country music and I love pop music. When you hear my stuff and the fact that I make what I make with sessions, I think that should be proof that I am really into pop music. I like a lot of top 40 music. It's very catchy. It's really great for getting into them, just for a good mood. But anyway, I digress. I just want to make sure that you guys understand that you shouldn't be afraid to listen to other music that's out there. It is there for us to eat up. It's there for people that aren't artists, but more importantly, I think it's there for people who are artists and do need inspiration and do need something more to open up, kind of, to broaden horizons, because I know it's definitely helped me broaden mine. So if you've got any questions about this tip, or if you've got any thoughts or concerns or just suggestions for future tips or anything regarding songwriting, just comment below and make sure that you share and like this video, and I will be sure to get back to you guys as soon as I can. Keep songwriting, keep producing, keep up your work in the music industry and business, and myself, along with Daniel and Tyler, are here to help you guys move your dreams forward in the music industry. All right, we'll catch you next time.